fish. Welcome back to Calypso's Cove, where the magic is our message. It is your mistress of magic, BlkAfroditee, here again with another pick a card. Today's pick a card theme is, how are you glowing up on the haters? You'll be picking from the photo on the thumbnail, pile one, pile two, or pile three. So that is going to be really exciting. I missed you guys so much. I hope you guys are doing well. To be honest, I'm just going with my own flow. When I feel the energy to do things, I just do it. I feel like that's kind of like a mermaid thing. I heard somebody say that about like Sade too. Like Sade has like this mermaid siren energy, and she just pops up on the random with beautiful music and then just disappears for a long period of time until she feels the energy and the vibe. So yeah, that's kind of me. I hope you guys have been well. I hope you guys have been learning since that full moon in Aquarius that was conjunct or doing something with Saturn. I forgot exactly whether it was opposing Saturn or conjunct Saturn. I wrote about it in the community tab. But yeah, that was really intense. I've learned a lot of lessons and didn't fall into old patterns, to say the least, when I was getting tested. So I'm proud of myself. I'm proud of you guys already. Thank you to all the new subscribers who have come into this temple. This is where we raise the divine feminine frequency through the magic, the power, the wisdom, the sexiness of Mama Ocean, mermaid, goddess vibes all day. So without further ado, let's get into the reading. Oh wait, hold up. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And turn on those post notifications too. That might help some of you see my videos. So yeah, now without further ado, let's get into the reading. Bye. Hello, those of you drawn to pile number one. This is for those of you who were drawn to the picture of Aphrodite, for how you are glowing up on your haters. Okay, so first I just want to start, you know, with some channeled messages from you picking Aphrodite. So from that, there's like a sense of you beginning to purify yourself. I feel a lot of cleansing, a lot of going within, a lot of revelations. And I know typically Aphrodite is known for love, but I'm really tapping into that energy of self-love and really truly putting yourself first and honoring yourself. It feels like there's something about you that's discovering new forms of happiness. There is a new version of happy, a new version of expressing joy that people around you are not used to experiencing, especially the haters. You're exploring this emotional peace in a way that you never have before, and I feel like you're really radiating so much beauty because of that. You're shining out to other people a clear space. When I think of water right now, I'm thinking of purification, because that's what water does. It purifies you. Born in your joy, born in your desires, or reborn, I should say. That's definitely what I'm picking up for just some channeled messages for pile number one. Also, you guys are feeling much more grounded in yourself. You're accepting yourself. Definitely spending more time alone, maybe. And really giving yourself the nurturance that you desire. Excuse me, that you desire and deserve. I tried to say both at the same time. You know, so you're really tapping into that frequency right now in terms of clearing yourself, especially from any relationships that might have been going a specific way. Maybe you were not really honoring yourself as much as you were honoring the people that you were in relationships with. So for those of you who are picking pile number one, you're definitely glowing up on your haters by just focusing in on yourself way more, taking care of yourself, spending a lot more time with yourself, kind of in like self-care mode. You're definitely in overdrive with self-care, and you're still very attractive. That's another thing too. So you've really stepped up your beauty pile number one. You're taking better care of yourself, taking better care of your skin, better care of your health. You're very much so wellness focused. I get that from you guys a lot as well. Really clearing the heart chakra too, seeing a lot of green. So it's like you cleansing and clearing your heart, clearing your womb area, basically like clearing out your emotions, making sure that you have emotional stability within yourself, taking care of yourself, and really putting yourself first, but not really in a, oh, I'm putting me first type of way, but really truly putting yourself first, remembering yourself, remembering that if you're not okay, then nothing else can function, nothing else can flourish. You know, you're really in that space right now on your haters, and they're not used to you doing that. They're not used to you putting yourself first. Especially, I'm channeling these narcissistic partners for some of you, or just people maybe that have wanted to come into your space, you know, want to talk to you, want your time, want your energy, and they are very upset that you're not reciprocating that or giving the energy that you used to give or that they want you to give. So let's start with the elements. So we have the element of space with inner listening. So yeah, you're definitely glowing up on your haters by really just tapping into your intuition more. You are very self-aware or very grounded in self, like I said before. So your intuition has really grown over the past couple of months, especially within the last 4 to 8 weeks. Your intuition has astronomically grown. Of course, it could be something in the sky with whatever is happening astrologically and how it affects your birth chart, but also this is just you. This is you taking the time to honor what it is that you feel, to honor how you feel, and to also expand upon that by embodying what it is that you actually feel, listening to yourself, listening to your ancestors, listening to your spirit guides. That's huge for you right now, really truly tapping in. So the next card we have is compassion, element of air. So yeah, you're definitely in the higher realms right now, pile number one. You're really connecting with your higher self and really diving deeper into just really getting into what pile number one needs, what pile number one feels. And that's the biggest flex you could ever do on anybody, especially people who aren't wishing you well, who want your life to go in a different direction because of their misery. You know, it's like the fact that you have a compassionate heart, the fact that you're still self-aware and honestly aware of what other people are going through and how other people feel and how they might project that onto you is really a blessing for them. And you're being a blessing to others by doing that because you're spreading lightness, you're spreading compassion. And killing people with that type of kindness is the most real flex you can ever possess because you're unbothered, you're detached with the element of air and compassion. Yeah, so you're expressing joy, you're expressing harmony, and you're understanding that everything has balance. So when it comes to dealing with your haters or dealing with people that don't really have the best interest in mind for you, you are definitely able to understand that in this reality, there's black, there's white, and there's the whole spectrum in between. Like, you understand balance. You understand why you had to learn certain lessons and why somebody might be feeling the way that they feel, and you do not hold it against them. You are able to let it go. You are able to move forward. You are able to forgive. You are able to show joy and gratitude. So it definitely says joy up here. So like I channeled earlier, you are expressing joy in a whole new way. Pile number one. And I feel like it kind of, it upsets people's demons, pile number one, when you do that. It upsets people's soul fragments, and it kind of shakes soul ties and energetic cords around people. Just whatever needs to be cut, whatever needs to be healed. Your inner joy is really doing that. The joy that you have for being the joy that you have for how you are, the way you love, the way you look, the way you work. So that's definitely making the haters upset, and you're glowing on them because of that. So next we have giving earth energy. So yeah, this is that groundedness that I was feeling. Big Taurus vibes. If you have Taurus, let me know in your chart. Sun, moon, rising, specifically moon, Venus, rising. Let me know, even Mars. Do you have a Taurus Mars? Maybe even Virgo? Let me know. Okay, so non-attachment, generosity, and steadfastness. Yes, you're glowing on your haters by not being detached. And I think that's very interesting that our Earth card came up and it still is showing non-attachment. It's still like in space, in an air element, you know? So it's like you're grounded in yourself, but also detached from the world around you. You're in the world and not of the world. You know what I mean? And that type of power, that type of control, calm control, is really, really powerful. And other people can get really angry from that. They can be resistant. They don't want to receive your generosity, pile number one. They don't want to know that your cup runneth over, you know, and that you're not stressed out and you're not sad that the dynamics between the people that you were connecting with at one point in time are no longer the same. You're completely okay with that. You're not missing out. You know, there's no FOMO here. You're really grounded in yourself. And you can still give when necessary. You're not leaving anybody high and dry. And I feel like that really makes everybody upset because they can't say the things that they want to say because it's not true in reality because you're still generous. You still give to people. You still answer the phone. You still provide, like, emotional support, financial support. You know, definitely some of you guys are very caretaking in terms of emotional care and emotional support, and you've been doing that so much, but now you're starting to give more to yourself. But that doesn't mean you're not available for the people around you. It really doesn't mean that. And people know that. That's how you're glowing, because you're like really moving from your intuition, from your heart, and I feel like that's a true love goddess. That's beautiful, because you're really moving from love. You're detached and you're still going to give. You're still going to be there for the people you care about. No matter what you guys went through. No matter if it was good, bad, or in between. You're still going to show the best of yourself. And also give to yourself.
Yeah, I was about to say like amen or ashe to that. Because that's beautiful. Alright, let's get into the tarot deck. Rider Waite. What other messages, spirit, do you have for my
those who are drawn to Goddess Aphrodite's image?
Spirit, what messages do you have for pile number one, three cards, please? Okay. We got exactly three. All right. And guys, you will have a different setup soon, and you'll be able to see the cards again. Just want to put that out there. You know, we switch it up. So the first card we have under inner listening is Page of Wands. So yeah, this really lets me know that this is a spiritual glow up, definitely. You are changing and you're consistently changing. I feel like this fire is transformation. So the more that you've listened to your intuition, the more that you change and you just look beautiful and ethereal on the outside. You're gorgeous, and you might not have a true upgrade in outfits or clothes, like that's what I'm hearing. Like, you might not be there all the way yet financially to do that, but just the way that you're carrying yourself, the way that you're supporting yourself and encouraging yourself, having that confidence is really making it look like you are worth $1 million, pile number one. You look wealthy, you're exuding wealth and health and creativity. Something is very lively about you. So from this glow up too, that's how you're glowing up on your haters, is you being able to connect to other people, being able to collaborate on creative endeavors, business opportunities, really being able to shine from listening to your intuition and benefiting from synchronicity, being at the right place at the right time. You might be receiving some items for free
might be getting a lot more compliments and a lot more attention. This is like it boy, it girl energy right here. Like, definitely you're the one, you're the star, main character, just from you listening to your intuition.
And being very tapped into that. Also, too, back to the creative ideas, you're opening up the access way to more revenue, more income, higher pay for those of you who want that. If you've been trying to manifest a new career, you're definitely going to be able to receive that. So that's really powerful. Next, under compassion, we have the Magician in reverse. So I feel like this is something you're still working on in terms of the compassion. But you're really working on changing your life. You're working on how you connect with your life and how your life, basically the dynamic between you and your life is very separate to me right now. And you're really working on how you actually interact with your life, and that includes the people in it as well. So how you feel about your day-to-day, how you feel about your job and your friends, and how you interact with all three of those, your family, is very, very important to you. And you're in the process of like molding and shaping that
pile number one.
And people are watching that happen. They're seeing you be the alchemist. They're seeing you take the different situations that you have in your life and the things that you've learned from it and trying to put it all together. But they really can't put a finger on what it is that you're doing yet. And that drives people insane. And there's a lot of projection on what it is that you're trying to. So people can't understand that you're trying to do a whole 360 with your life and change up your environment, move to a different place, have new friends, whatever it is that you're doing, because it's like you're really purifying yourself right now. You're really changing up everything. So people are really like drawn to what you're doing and want to know, hey, what is pile number one manifesting? What is pile number one really working on? Like, why are they changing like this? Where are they about to go? Where are they about to be? Who are they about to meet? People are very, very nosy. Very nosy, pile number one. It's driving them crazy. And you've just been like very compassionate, very poised, forgiving, understanding. And people are like going insane over wondering where you're about to end up because they know that you're shifting and changing and people are noticing you. And you're still just the same pile number one that you've always been, keeping it 100% real, moving from the heart. But now you're giving that to yourself and things are in the works for you. It's really giving star quality, you know, local star, global star, whichever. You know, you're going to have your own environment where people are going to be looking to you for a lot of things. And the haters in your life are really upset about it, you know, because they're used to having your energy all to themselves. They don't want to share your energy with anybody. That's, you know, the narcissistic dynamic. If you're dealing with that, that could be friends, coworkers, family members, lovers, maybe even sometimes your own children or, you know, it just depends. Even pets can be, you know, kind of like, I need you, I need you.
So, next we have the Hierophant. And I think this is very interesting under giving because this is showing that, you know, this is more Taurus energy, so you really might have some strong Earth or strong Taurus energy in your birth chart because I really feel that for you guys. Maybe even Capricorn, let me know. Could be some fixed air, like Aquarius, something kind of close to that type of vibration, but definitely giving Taurus. Maybe even Leo, but I'm feeling Earth and Taurus the most. Okay, so you're definitely in a position of still giving very, like, sage and wise advice to people. You're very much so in a position where you're still able to emotionally give, still able to answer the phone, like I said, still able to provide really structure for the people around you. The people around you are really used to you providing that type of structure for them. They're used to you being there and kind of giving the blueprint on what to do. You're kind of like the emotional boss of people around you. And they're seeing you kind of step up to a higher position where you can actually receive real payment for that.
you know, real energetic reciprocity, because in these dynamics, you know, you're not really getting that. But here, these people are bent down to the Pope. You know, they're looking at the Pope as a godlike figure, somebody who's an authority figure, and I feel like that's you. It's giving authority figure. And at the same time, this is an authority figure who's supposed to be a representation of God and the community. And I feel like that's how people in your life are really seeing you, Pile Number One. And it's, as much as they hate it, they have no choice but to admire it. They have no choice but to bow down and accept who you are and where you're headed and what you've always been.
And the fact that you're so giving, the fact that your power is for the community, a lot of red here, a lot of root chakra. You help people with their root needs. You really get to the root of the issue. You really handle the root of the problem when it comes to people around you, emotionally, mentally. And people can't disrespect that. As much as they want to try, as much as they want to act like you might not really be coming from the heart, you are. It's the core of you. And that's not going to change, even with you growing into a position of authority. And really changing your life in however that is. I'm seeing for some of you, you guys could be becoming like a head nurse, or just maybe you work in like the health services department. Maybe you work with children. Maybe you might become a head chef. It really just depends on what you do. So that is something that people are having to wrap their mind around, because you are glowing up. So I'm going to just do one of each from the last couple decks so we can wrap up our meeting. Okay, Spirit. From the Believe in Your Own Magic deck. Next, we'll go to Goddesses, Gods, and Guardians. Spirit, what message do you have for Pile Number One? Okay. And then the African Goddess Rising deck. Last card. Spirit, what last message do you have? Five, so a lot of change. I'm so happy for you. Bottom of the deck is Oshun, Fearless Love. You guys gotta forgive my nail broke. What can you do? Okay, so from the Believe in Your Own Magic deck, which says a lot, you have a burning tree, and that's just talking about roots and being people's roots. It says let them go. Under the Page of Wands, so people are really upset that you're glowing up because you're listening to the intuition and letting go of who needs to be let go and really releasing who needs to be released. Under the Magician and Compassion, you have Rhiannon. Beautiful moon, more intuition, more divine feminine energy, inner strength. Okay, so you are using your inner strength to remain compassionate, to remain vigilant. Rhiannon's story is she had to be forgiven from everything that people were trying to falsely accuse her of in her village that she was from. And she literally had to rise against everything that people were saying and everything that people were pushing on her with compassion and love. So this is a very powerful message. And the colors are very similar too, with that indigo kind of blue hue to it. And underneath the Hierophant and giving, we have Mubia Nahanda, Radical Rebirth. And I think that's so powerful underneath the Hierophant and giving, because you have the strength, okay? You have the ability, and I want you to really see this card. If I can get it outside of the ring light. Look at her strength. Look at her stance. Look at how she's standing upright in her regality. You know, really standing up for who she is. And I think that radical rebirth of you kind of coming into your authority as the Hierophant is really, really powerful. And this is a way that you can give to yourself. This is a way that you can also give to your community. Pile number one. Because I feel like you're a very giving person. You're very love-centered, family-centered, community-centered person. In some form of fashion, you just really care about people. You might be an advocate. So this radical rebirth will help you really come into your life's purpose. And that's gorgeous. So this will conclude your reading as to how you're glowing up on the haters right now. I really hope you enjoyed. Until we meet again. Bye-bye. Namaste. I honor your ancestors. I honor your spirit guides. Thank you for sharing your energy with me. Hi, pile number two. This is for those of you who were drawn to the second picture or goddess Hathor. So if you were drawn to picture number two, pile number two, goddess Hathor, this is the pile. I just want to start off by kind of getting into the vibe. I think we're going to start with the original Rider-Waite tarot deck first, and then just have some channel messages. So let's see, please. Let's see, spirit, what messages do you have for pile? Those who were drawn to the goddess Hathor, beautiful Egyptian goddess of music, of joy, of merriment, of love and lovemaking, of beauty, of motherhood, of nourishment. She who too has many epithets, many names. Ooh, we got four. Spirit is saying, just like, and I think I'm going to keep the bottom of the deck so you guys have five cards. Okay. Spirit is saying, just like Goddess Hathor, who's known for the many things that she can do, you, pile number two, are also glowing up and evolving to this aspect of yourself as a multifaceted, multi-talented, multi-dimensional being. Okay, there's so many things that you are good at. Pile number two, so many ways that you can express yourself. For you guys, for everybody who's drawn to this energy of pile number two, it's really about expression and self-expansion in the most confident, exuberant, passionate, loud way. And this is really giving like that Leo Venus energy that we're in right now. So you guys are having like an awakening to this, a glow up to the side of yourself that's so talented at so many different things, and being able to work that. I'm even hearing the word flaunt. So even being able to flaunt it, being able to shimmy and shake through life, having a lot more energy behind the things that you do and how you show up in the world. So there's a lot of that right now. And, you know, let's just get into the tarot card to go, to go further into the messages that Spirit has. Because here we have the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So people are so used to you, pile number two, coming off as very shy, very reserved, almost laid back. Somebody that used to be considered maybe number two, kind of like a side So really be flexible in your approach to understanding this. There could have been a way that people expected you to be on the sideline, pile number two, and no longer will you do that, but you've learned a lot of lessons as Queen of Pentacles. Because you've been kind of waiting for the right opportunity to present yourself, to show who you really are on the inside, you've learned a lot about playing the game of life, pile number two. You've understood how to make money. So you've really understood how to manifest wealth. You've understood how to show up at work and how to get along with coworkers, how to take advantage of opportunities around you. You've been patient. You've stacked your money. You've listened to different things. You've listened to different podcasts and watched different YouTube videos and really seen different foods that you want to try, different hairstyles that you want to do, or different colors, different things that you wanted to add to your wardrobe. And you were stacking and stacking and stacking in secret. And people thought that you didn't have those type of interests. People thought you didn't care about fashion, or maybe didn't care about healthcare products, skin products, shoes, business ideas, business deals, different ventures on how to make passive income, residual income. People didn't think that you were on that. People didn't think that you wanted to create your own business. But now you are no longer waiting. Now you are no longer just presenting yourself as a shy person or somebody who wants to be in the background, somebody who doesn't have ideas and can't be seen. You're presenting yourself in a totally different way now. You're reborn, because after this, we have the Star card, and it's so beautiful how these tarot cards tell a story for you guys. Because now you're shining in your star power. So there's a lot of star power in these piles. I love that for you guys. You have been reborn from gestating with that earth goddess or queen of pentacles energy. You were really gestating. You were waiting for the right time to harvest and to bloom. You know, that blossoming took time. You had to have the right amount of sunlight and the right amount of months and conditions. You had to be under the proper conditions to really go through this rebirth, pile number two, and now you're here. And or the people who don't support you had their own agenda. They're very shocked. They don't know who this new person is at the water. They don't know who this new person is, who the star is. They're not used to seeing you like that, pile number two. They're used to you being in the background. They're kind of used to you having ideas and seeming like they never really follow through. Or you might just have something in the cut and they're always like, oh, you should be doing this, or you should be doing that, and you never say anything to them. So they've never taken you seriously, but now here you are in your integrity, reborn as a star, ready to fully shine, and they are shook, okay? People around you are very, very nervous. That's what I picked up on, especially in the beginning, because I just had to take a second and break down what it is that I really felt. And people around you are deeply, deeply nervous, pile number two, because they're nervous of this star quality. They're nervous about this power, because they're like, dang, it's almost like, you know, you don't mess with the quiet person, because you never know what the quiet person feels or thinks or has going on. So yeah, definitely it's a little difficult for people, because they're very, very nervous about how you're going to take things and where you're going to go and how you're going to shine your light. So you have a lot of people around you that might not necessarily be hating per se, but they do at the same time have their reservations. They want to control you. And I mean, honestly, they probably are really hating on you, because they wanted to be like you for a very long time. They've been trying to prove, right, that they are better than you. And again, with Leo Venus. So Leo Venus might be having like a really powerful connection, or you might be having a really powerful transit with Leo Venus, which shining that light of your worth and your self-value and what you bring to the table. And on the flip side of that, that can bring out competition. just like how they feel, you're starting to exude from yourself this deep well of inner confidence that you now have, that people, first of all, it's not now have, it's always been there. Now you just have all of your needs, all of the things that you needed to manifest this truth, this real version of yourself, like your higher self in this human form. You're ready to do that now. And people are like, whoa, it's almost like you're busting out of the seams, pile number two. And they really don't know what to feel or how to feel about it. They're just kind of shook. And I guess that is the fear of not having control of you anymore. And you just being in your own integrity, you being in your own truth and shining your light, regardless if anyone's around you or not, you know? There's a lot of cards where there's just a soul figure on the card. So you are really focused in on yourself. And Hathor is a goddess that represents relationships, but she also represents that self-love first. And you're really doing that, especially when it comes to your creativity. Because next we have the Page of Wands. So there's something about you, something that you have going on, a vision, new job. I mean, the idea of what it could be, excuse me, is endless. I have the hiccups. The idea of what it could be is endless, but excuse me, there's something going on, and my throat chakra is a little blocked. So you've been having to not speak on this for a very long time, 11-11. You've been having to hold this in and hold this passion that you have inside of you within for a while, and now you're just ready to burst out, and it's like people don't want to hear what it is that you really have going on. People don't want to know the creative ventures that you have and what you feel and what you think. And I feel like that block, that control that people try to have over you, that tight rein, you're just bursting that into flames with this Page of Wands, and you're coming out in this passion and like this fire, this new zest for life to other people, old to you, new to them. You remember when we used to have that as a caption? Old to me, new to you. Like, yeah, that's how it is.
You're so confident. You know, it's like an inner glow. It's an inner fire. It's beautiful. And, you know, it's making new people want to come into your life. Definitely, because we have the Ace of Cups here. So new people, new opportunities, just an open door policy for everything that's new and refreshing. How about that? Refreshing, rejuvenating. Something that induces peace and does not add to your stress, and also promotes more expansion, more creativity, spiritual purity, you know, moving from your heart. You're open to all those type of experiences. And your haters are just kind of like, what about us? Like, what about me? It's, a really narcissistic type of dynamic. You know, where people are so used to you being able to give to them and seeming like you are the main focus all the time. Their issues or their drama or whatever it is that they had going on, they were so used to you seeming available.
And now you're just not. And I'm really seeing a theme in this reading, because this is like also kind of like a theme from the first pile as well, which is really focusing in on yourself and not really feeding those dynamics in the same way. But it seems like for you, unlike pile number one, you are done giving that extra energy to people that you feel like no longer deserve it. There's a lot of cups energy here. So cups are being poured onto the ground, poured back into the water right here, and then a cup is also overflowing. So to me, this is emotional reciprocation.
What's going on? You are nourishing the ground around you. You're also giving back to what nourishes you with pouring the water inside of the lake, and then you have enough, the cup runneth over, to continue that cycle of nourishing the ground that you walk on, the steps that you take, and giving back and basically being thankful, being grateful, understanding, and really giving to what gives to you, to people too, giving to people who give to you, being there for people who are there for you.
Emotional reciprocation is huge right now for everybody, it seems. And then last card we have is the Empress in reverse. Okay, she's gestating still, you know, and so are you. I really feel that. You're getting to this place. You're really getting initiated into being the real life embodiment of an Empress. Someone who has the fire and the drive to achieve their goals. The open-mindedness and the lightness to have a new mentality and create new habits and new patterns and release old things that no longer serve you and detach. You know, somebody who has emotional wellness and empathy and understanding and intuition. And then someone who is grounded and knows how to take their time and understands the earth and nature and plants and other people. You know, having that type of mindset is what really makes you an Empress. And with Hathor there backing it, it's like, this isn't the embodiment of self-love, of self-expression. This is you actually expressing yourself. This is who you are. This is what you do. You know, you are meant to shine in this way. You're meant to have these new situations. You're meant to move forward. And honestly, if you need to, strong cord cutting energy for you all. So there's been cords that you've been attached to for a little while that the fire that you have within you has just naturally burned off. Archangel Michael, like, the cord is cut. The fiery flames have dissolved it of transmutation. The flame of transmutation has burned it away. The glow up has burned it away. And it might take some time, you know, because you have a lot of earth energy here. You have almost like every element, because I consider the star card like air. So you have earth, air, water, fire, and then you have the Empress. So that's really, really powerful. So you're really in harmony and in balance too. And whatever is not here to serve you is really dissolving. So let's get into the elements deck with the mudras. See any additional messages for you, how you're routine, how you're switching it up, how you're blowing up on your haters right now. According to the goddess Hathor, okay, fire, you got fire, I'm gonna put one more. One more card, please, spirit, for my beautiful pile number two. Okay, and then we got earth, wow. Absolutely. And then right underneath that is straight up the fire element. Absolutely. So we have first fire.
And that's what I'm talking about, that hot fire inside of you. If you can see that, that's assimilation.
So spiritual discipline, transformation, and willpower. Yeah, there's some people who really like don't want you to speak. Throat chakra blocks, big time. But this is burning all of that away. So you're kind of like burning through and changing your DNA. That's how I'm taking the assimilation. You're really, really like changing yourself, kind of going through the emotional as well as like the physical aspects of you changing. You might be in the process of losing weight or gaining weight, like I said, changing your hair, getting ready to change where you live, getting ready to change your appearance, maybe even changing your spiritual views as well. And just getting prepared after you have all the knowledge, or maybe you're about to graduate from something and you're just getting prepared for this next transition in your life, with you really switching and assimilating to this new version of self, opening up these new patterns and this new form of DNA and really coming into that and activating it within your body and using that fire to just burn off anything that doesn't serve you. Because, I mean, it doesn't. Next, we have stability, which is earth, so releasing, calming, grounding. And I know that, again, a lot of releasing energy, releasing a lot of soul ties. You had a lot of connections, a lot of cord, energetic cord and you're becoming stable in yourself, and Hathor is really here also as a guide, and you guys can start working with her. She's suggesting just the ideas, the principles behind what she stands for in terms of you expressing yourself and not feeling bad about it. And you're releasing people who can't understand that. You're releasing people who don't get that, as well as becoming really stable and being yourself for yourself without needing any codependent relationships, any codependent aspects of dealing with other people. Really grounded and rooted in self, deeply rooted into the earth that is you. You're the ground, you know, and be grounded in that, you know, your connection to God, your connection to your family, to the things that really matter to you. Family could be pets, could be friends, could be whatever it is that you need it to be. Just being really connected to your roots, the root of who you are in that core, is really powerful. You're glowing on your haters with that. So I'm just going to pull one more message, I think, from the Believe in Your Own Magic. Spirit. So the first card is another 19, so this is definitely the end of a cycle. And this says lavender, surround yourself with love. So you are definitely, like I said, new connections are going to be formed for you, pile number two, and people are going to be coming into your life that deeply love you and deeply understand you. Lavender, you're going to have a lot of mental ease, peace, calm, and de-stressing going on in your life. And then we have 36, gold. You don't need someone else to fix you. And like I said, you're really understanding that. You're getting that, you know, you don't need to surround yourself with certain people or deal with certain people to experience that type of love. You're giving it to yourself.
And that's really, really beautiful. So that will conclude your reading, pile number two, on how you're glowing up on the haters. I hope you enjoyed this reading. I just want to take the time to honor your spirit guides, your ancestors of pile number two. Thank you for sharing your energy with me. Namaste. Until we meet again. Bye. Hi, pile number three. This is for those of you who are drawn to the image for pile number three, which is Goddess Ishtar. So if you were drawn to pile number three's image, Goddess Ishtar, then this is pile for you. I feel like I have to ask you guys how you're doing. Are you feeling well? Are you feeling blessed? Are you feeling protected? Are you feeling safe in your skin? Because these are all the things that Ishtar wishes for you, despite the haters. Yes, ma'am. Some of y'all are having some issues with coworkers and deciding what to do with yourself, deciding where to go. You have so many options. Some of you are really having to balance your personal life and your work life. Work might be starting to consume some of you. I instantly started channeling some dealings with coworkers, maybe some issues or just something going on with the work environment. Taking the time to just kind of sink in. Yeah, so I'm getting a channel of Ishtar's energy and just kind of being like, when will you release? When will you let go? And for some of you, that definitely needs to happen. The first card we have is the Two of Pentacles in reverse. So there's something that's out of balance.
And when I think about the picture for Ishtar, she's standing there so beautifully, so boldly in her power. Full moon behind her, rose petals. So tapped into the sacred power of what it means to be a woman, strength and intuition. And also the beauty and the majestic energy behind it. And there's something out of balance with that when it comes to you. Pile number three. When it comes to your work, when it comes to your energy, this is your energy currency being out of balance. And Hathor is wanting you to feel the things that I asked you earlier. Like, she wants you to feel, excuse me, not Hathor. Hathor might have a message for you guys, but Ishtar. Ishtar might want you guys to feel that way. This is just a really deep channel because now we're getting into like some goddess messages, because Ishtar is really showing up hardcore for the principles of what she represents, right? Ishtar is a goddess who represents love and war and the fight behind what we would do to procure our desires. You know, like when we think about war, it's really the desire to have something, to maybe have land, to have materials, raw goods. It's all a desire. So that passion to fight over it is almost the exact same thing as the intensity of being deeply in love. And have you been fighting for the right reasons? Pile number three. Have you really been coming into the situations, understanding what it is that you're really adding to it? And how much energy you're giving it. Because your haters, pile number three, are people that you don't really consider haters. This is something that's kind of hidden from you a little bit, but at the same time, you're very aware. We have a two here. So two means cooperation, balance, codependency. Okay? There's something going on with you and another person. Or you might be, and this could be any situation, it doesn't have to be a person. It could be you giving too much to work, too much energy, spending too much time focusing on something that, you know, maybe this could be codependency with substances, or this could be codependency on food or your cell phone. Just some way where you're giving a lot of energy to something that might not necessarily serve you. And for some of you, this is work-related, especially with the pentacle here. Something going on in terms of you and work and not really balancing your currency, your energy, and then what you do with your energy. Especially when it comes to your work, it feels like you have other things, and there are people around you who have been blocking that a little bit, and you've been allowing them to because you haven't been seeing outside of that, feeding and feeding and feeding whatever the situation is, because it's different for all of you with this being a general meeting. But there's something going on where you're not giving to yourself in the way that you need to, and you're so strong, you're so brilliant, you're so beautiful. And what I mean strong is you have a strong presence, you have a strong aura, you know, strong mind, strong heart, a resilient heart, a resilient spirit. And your spirit guides and your ancestors really want you to come into a place where you respect that and can see other horizons. Okay, because we have the Three of Wands right here. So they want you to create something, create a new chapter. You know, come into a new place. See the different possibilities of what's there for you. Pile number three. And the way you're going to glow up on your haters is stopping limiting beliefs. You are really working on changing your mind, changing your perspective, going beyond what it is you feel like you might deserve or feel like you would receive, and really dreaming that beautiful dream of what is possible. Because it seems like for a long time, you haven't been doing that. Pile number three, you've just been kind of going with the flow and allowing yourself to just kind of get whatever you know, so if you have friends and they're not the best friends, well, hey, at least I have friends. Or you're dating somebody and they're not the most consistent, but it's like, hey, at least they're here at all. Or you have a job that you don't really like that much. You actually might really get drained from it and it takes a lot out of you. You know, you don't get paid as much as you should adequately, but hey, at least I have money. You know, you've been feeling that way for so long, pile number three. But now it's like the biggest glow up that you could have on your haters, people that expect you to kind of keep giving energy, to kind of stay in the same position, stay in the same places, as imagining yourself in these new spaces where that beautiful light, you know, from the picture from Ishtar can shine. You need to shine. And in order to do that, you have to change your perspective, and that's how you're glowing up on your haters right now. Really changing your perspective, changing your mind, understanding, you know, with the new values that you have on things, the new things that you want, the new things that you want to receive from people. Okay, the new friends that you might want to have, the new foods you might want to taste. It's all up to you. You have the ability, of wands, to create whatever it is that you want to create. It's up to you. Nobody can stop you. Nobody will block you but yourself. Okay? And for some of you, it's like, are you your biggest block? You know, are you the hater that you're trying to get away from? Pile number three. You know, and that's just something that has to be thought about for some of you guys who picked this pile, who have been too afraid to step out of your comfort zone and stop giving energy to things that you know doesn't serve you. You know that. You don't even have to think about it. It's just something that you've known for a long time. You've been maybe dissatisfied or uncomfortable or unhappy for a really long time. And now it's getting to the point where you can't participate in this the same way that you used to. You have to be the Knight of Swords, charging into this with a new mindset, with gusto. And you might not be like taking the time to fully think things through right now, but I think the best thing that you can do is just be open to diving into these new experiences, regardless of the within the people who keep you small and within yourself keeping yourself small. Pile number three. Diving into these new opportunities without fear, just like the Knight of Swords. Telling yourself daily affirmations. Allowing yourself, you know, more reading, more research. Research on different areas, how different people live. Research on different cultures. Understanding different people's perspectives. Maybe you'll meet some people that are more similar to you. I'm really picking up a soul tribe energy here, where you can actually connect to people that are like-minded or help you curate new thought processes or processes, however you say that. And really coming into this new awareness of self that promotes growth and that promotes emotional satisfaction, emotional well-being, because that's what you've really been craving. You've been craving that emotional well-being, that new vibration for such a long time. And I think there was a part of you that just felt like, okay, like if I could just be comfortable with where I am, if I can just allow myself to just keep making the money and keep being stable, I will never be disappointed. I won't be flat on my bum looking for help. And I think a lot of you guys have been kind of concerned with that. Not looking for new friends that you can't trust and don't know how people are. Not in a vulnerable situation where you can get your heart broken. And there's just been a lot of fear. A lot of fear from you stepping into this Three of Wands energy, these new horizons. And that's why you don't mind giving your energy to things that you know don't really serve you, or you're lowballing yourself energetically. Which is not fair to you, not at all. However, you're content with that, and now you can't be anymore. And that's how you're glowing. glowing up on the people around you. That's how you're glowing up on people who don't really want you to expand. You know, that's a real hater. A hater doesn't want you to move forward. A hater doesn't want you to expand beyond what it is that you've known and actually add more knowledge and actually add more wealth and more health. Haters don't necessarily want that. Haters want you to continue to be the same old person that you've been. You know? And now you can't even rest. It's like you're restless with this Knight of Swords. You can't rest until you experience that new version of yourself. You can't rest until you're able to go forward and move forward for you.
And then we have the Ten of Cups. So this is definitely the end of a cycle for you. You know, you getting to this emotional fulfillment and being emotionally satisfied with your life is one of the greatest upgrades, the greatest glow-ups that you can have in this lifetime. Everybody is searching for that. Everybody is looking for that type of emotional fulfillment that makes you feel whole, that makes you feel like you're not out here searching. And the fact that you need to go out to new places and experience new things really does let me know that there are people waiting for you in those spaces that are going to fill you up with so much love and joy. And you being open to that, being open to these people who are there for you. You can't see them yet, but they're there. Real friends, you know? A job that you really love. A situation, a house that really makes you happy. A car that makes you happy. You know, it's there for you as long as you open up your mind to receive that. And Ishtar is such an open person, but it's like there's like this conflict or like this tension that you might have had with the idea of doing that or with the people around you. And how that need to experience your desire can sometimes turn into something that can be a little argumentative or maybe even a toxic experience where you're experiencing your shadow with people because you're just not living your truth. So you're starting arguments and starting fights and acting really aggressive, or people around you might be displaying that they're getting really aggressive with you, really angry, really short, because it's like you're just bubbling up to experience this desire that you need so deeply and so badly to express.
Some more additional messages.
So Spirit, what are some other messages for Pile number 3? Okay. Spirit, what are some additional messages for Pile number 3? Two more cards, please. Spirit, what are some additional messages for those who are drawn to Goddess Ishtar? Period. What is the last message for Pile number 3? Okay. Alright, so protect your energy is at the bottom of the deck. Dryads, tree spirit, nature spirits are there protecting you. Okay, so the first card we have is Mary Magdalene. I'll put it over here. Mary Magdalene. This is more rose petals too. So I really do feel like there's something going on with you in terms of femininity, protecting yourself, protecting your emotions, maybe protecting your sacred desires. And with sacred marriage here, oh my gosh, excuse me. Anyway, with sacred marriage here, really feeling like, what are you connected to? Because this is right near that Two of Pentacles in reverse. So what are you giving the majority of your energy to? Because whatever you're giving it to, you're connected to Pile number 3. You're tied to that. Okay, so that's really important to remember. Really analyze
And then you have Asclepios, Asclepios, Sacred Medicine. So this is sacred twice. So this is something that's really a major aspect in your life right now. So really understanding what you're connected to, what you're in union with, what you're giving your energy to will be very healing for you. Pile number three, and will really promote real glow up, real health, real spiritual health and wellness and transformation. Okay, and you really need